Hello, and welcome to today's video presentation on creating a Linux virtual machine using VirtualBox 6.1 on Oracle Linux 8. This video will focus on installing the latest Oracle Linux 8 at the time of this recording into a VirtualBox VM using both the graphical interface and the command line. So let us get started. This video uses a pre-installed Oracle Linux 8 physical system with VirtualBox 6.1. If using VirtualBox installed on a compute instance of Oracle Cloud Infrastructure, there will be differences in the desktop environment navigation steps depending on whether using Oracle Linux 7 or Oracle Linux 8. First, open a VirtualBox graphical interface by clicking Activities in the upper left corner of the screen. Next, use the search text field and find the open VirtualBox application by starting to type its name. Click the Oracle VM VirtualBox icon. Once the Oracle VM VirtualBox Manager opens, click the round blue new icon. Since this will be an Oracle Linux 8.2 VM, ensure you have the ISO file staged somewhere on the system where the user performing the installation has access. For this demo, the staged file is in the user's home directory. After clicking the new icon, the Create Virtual Machine dialog box will appear. Provide the name OL8-test-vbox for the VM in the name field. Keep the default machine folder location, which is /home/Oracle/VirtualBox VMs in this environment. Change the type list of values to Linux and the version list of values to Oracle 64-bit. Click the Next button. Next, adjust the slider or type the amount of memory to be allocated to the value of 2048 and click the Next button. Use the Create a Virtual Hard Disk Now option and click the Create button. Use the default option of VDI, VirtualBox Disk Image, and click the Next button. For storage on the physical hard disk, select Dynamically Allocated. Using Dynamically Allocated, the VM only uses space on the physical disk as the VM fills up. Click the Next button. Use the default location and disk name provided in the dialog window. Adjust the slider or type the virtual hard disk size to allocate the capacity to 20 GB, then click the Create button. Now scroll through and view the settings summary. Next, make a few recommended settings changes from the defaults based on your environment. To make those changes, click the orangish-yellow settings gear icon in the panel above the summary. First, navigate on the left and click System. Under the Motherboard tab and Pointing Device list of values, change the value to USB tablet. This change helps avoid mouse pointer issues in some environments, such as when using VNC to connect to the VirtualBox host. When using VNC, the VM mouse cursor might become out of sync with the physical mouse cursor. Next, if running a graphical desktop environment within the VM, increase the video memory to the max value possible. Navigate on the left and click Display. Adjust the slider or type in the value of video memory to the max setting of 128 MB. Next, navigate on the left and click Network. By default, VirtualBox assigns a NAT-based network to Adapter 1. A NAT-based network is beneficial if running the VM behind a VPN and only concerned that the VM has network access. If wanting to access the VM from the same network as the host without port forwarding, change the setting attached to for Adapter 1 to Bridged Adapter. If you want more information about different network settings, check out the VirtualBox documentation. For this demo, leave the Adapter 1 attached to NAT. Click OK and close the VM settings dialog. With the settings complete, click the green Start arrow icon. As the VM performs the initial boot, it recognizes the need for an installable media. Click the folder arrow icon on the right, which opens the optical disk selector dialog. As there are no media files currently in the list, click the Add icon. Navigate in the file dialog to the location where you previously staged the Oracle Linux 8 ISO file. For this demo, the file is in the user's home directory. Double-click the file to select it. Highlight the ISO file in the selector dialog and click the Choose button. From the Select Startup Disk dialog, click the Start button. The VM will boot and load the installation boot screen. Shortly after boot, VirtualBox will display a few notifications regarding the capture of the keyboard and mouse. To disable these notifications, click the comment icon in the notification panel with the blue slash. Now, click in the VM running window. The first time performing this action will display a dialog about how the VM captures the mouse. The dialog also provides information on how to release the capture of the mouse and return control to the host machine. Click the Capture button to confirm giving mouse control to the VM. Proceed and complete the installation. As the installation takes a while to complete, we will fast forward to the end. If there are questions on how to complete the installation of Oracle Linux 8, check out our existing videos at oracle.com/go-to/Oracle Linux Learning. When the installation is complete, click the Reboot button. The VM will reboot. Once the VM boots, approve the license agreement and finalize any OS installation steps after logging into the VM. That completes the Linux Guest VM installation using the VirtualBox graphical interface. Now, install another VM using the VirtualBox command line. Open a terminal. The benefit of using the VirtualBox command line is using VirtualBox in a headless environment. First, change your directory to the VirtualBox default directory by typing cd space double quote forward slash home forward slash oracle forward slash VirtualBox space VMS double quote forward slash. Using this directory helps keep all VM files located in the VirtualBox default folder. Make a folder based on the name of the new VM. In this demo, type makedir space ol8-test-cli and then cd into that directory. Next, create a 20 GB dynamic disk by typing the command on the screen and hit enter. The displayed output indicates the medium created. Next, get a list of the OS types recognized by VirtualBox. To narrow the output and display only the ID for OS types related to Oracle, type vboxmanage space list space OS types space pipe space grep space dash I space Oracle space pipe space grep space dash I space ID. The output displays the Oracle 32-bit and Oracle 64-bit IDs. Next, create the VM by typing the command on the screen and hit enter. The output displays the virtual machine created successfully, the VM UUID, and the VM settings file location. With the VM created, next, add a SATA controller with a dynamic disk attached. Type the commands on the screen and hit enter after each one. Next, add an IDE controller with a DVD attached and the installation ISO inserted into the drive by typing the commands shown on the screen. Hit enter after each command. Wrap the path to the ISO file in single quotes if the path contains spaces. Lastly, add these additional settings based on changes made during the graphical interface install. Enable IO APIC by typing vboxmanage space modify VM space ol8-test-cli space dash dash IO APIC space on. Next, set the mouse pointer to USB tablet, VM system memory to 2048 GB, and the video memory to 128 MB. Type vboxmanage space modify VM space ol8-test-cli space dash dash mouse space USB tablet space dash dash memory space 2048 space dash dash VRAM space 128. If running the network using a bridged adapter, type the command shown on the screen. The adapter BR0 in the command shown is the bridge network for the physical NIC on the host system. Once making all these changes, start the VM by typing vboxmanage space start VM space ol8-test-cli. The VM will boot and is ready to finish the OS installation. That completes this demo of creating a Oracle Linux VM using VirtualBox graphical interface and the command line. More details are available in the VirtualBox documentation. Thank you for watching this video and enjoy using VirtualBox on Oracle Linux 8. Please check our additional information on Oracle Linux 8 in the Oracle Linux 8 documentation or Oracle Linux Learning Library.